Meet the artist behind the large effigies at the Love Burn 2020 event, the Strong Woman Project. Here we have CC Currie and Wally being interviewed by Prosperity and Quantum Glen. So how was the experience of building an effigy at the Love Burn?
It was amazing start to finish. Like I said, it was actually talking to Prosperity at a party that got me inspired, actually. And that night came up with a concept, and then it just rolled on from there. And, you know, having a great group of Palm Beach builders and stuff to back me up and help me out with all this. And yeah, you guys were awesome with helping us too, with Jeff at the Dragonfly Studios cutting and getting us all set up and really guiding us through the whole process and everything. So it was really, really awesome experience.
And yeah. Fun.
Yes.
And the talking about at the party was because you'd already made something so amazing that was over the top. That's why I was like, wait, she can do something even bigger. That's how it started. It was because you already did something that prompted the conversation. So.
Yeah, but it was actually, I never had an inkling that I would ever try and even design an effigy yet, you know, like maybe down the line, but it was just like, yeah, let's try this, let's do this. And, you know, like you said, it was the year of the woman, the Matriarch Reloaded kind of thing. And it's like, we're looking for women, you know, and I'm like, okay, well, let's give it a shot. And so, yeah, and the design just kind of lent itself to itself, so.
Oh, it really did.
So why don't you talk about how you found out about Love Burn and mm-hmm. how you got inspired to make the piece?
Okay, well, Love Burn, my first year going to Love Burn was 2018, actually. I'd gone to the Big Burn twice at that point, and finally I was like, well, let me go do Love Burn. So I did 2018, and I just solo camped, checked it out. That was the year they had the Big Globe, and it was amazing. And the next year, I got better acquainted with more Palm Beach burners, and they had made a shipwreck awesome built thing that they did at Okeechobee Fest and everything, and they brought it to Afterburn, and then they brought it to Love Burn, and the theme was Taboo, Island of Taboo in 2019, and so to add to it, I did some tentacles around the shipwreck. Going to something only an hour away was so much easier to bring big art to, because the Big Burn, it's like, it's very hard to even get yourself out there. And that was when they were like, oh, the theme is Matriarch Reloaded. You know, we're looking for women to design the effigy. And I'm like, oh, that sounds great, but that's a bit much. You know, I thought just doing my tentacles the year before was like, wow, that was a big project. So I went home, but I couldn't get the thought out of my head. And when I thought of, okay, well, if the man were to be a strong woman, what would it look like? And I just automatically thought of Rosie the Riveter with the We Can Do It logo and everything. And so that emulated strong women. So then I started sketching and coming up with ideas, and I passed them by some of my friends. They're like, oh, that's really cool. You should try that. So, you know, I talked to you guys about like what's expected, what really is incorporated into doing this effigy. And since I had Wally and a bunch of other friends from the Palm Beach group that did that big shipwreck thing and seeing what they could throw together in just a few weeks' time, I was like, well, maybe these people will help me do this. So I asked around, and a lot of people were on board, and we just made it happen. So I sent in the design. You guys liked it, and gave me the opportunity to prove myself and, you know, put a paper and pen to reality. So it was really amazing, and everybody really came together. The community, we have such a great community of artists and go-getters and doers and stuff. And Wally here is just, he's an amazing taskmaster kind of guy. You know, he does that for a living as it is. So having him in my corner was a big help.
Wally, you were awesome. You both were amazing and incredible. I mean, and the project came together so, so well.
Yeah, we had lots of talent.
Dirk helped us with this small
thing. Lee, you're right in design mode right there.
Right. Doing the arms. Getting the head done with the iconic polka dot head kerchief that Rosie wears. And we're in a 10 by 20 carport thing we propped up in a backyard to build in.
With the
LED lights on.
Lights in the head.
Yeah, and then Heathen helping with the handkerchief. She's a sewing master. Putting her all together. There's her pelvis.
Yeah, and then I was loading it to the truck.
Loading it
right
on
there.
It was a rainy, rainy night. And there's Josh and Jenny who did some of the portraits. They did the Phoenix woman there.
Pyro art.
They use the pyrography with our friend Sanders there. They got a lot of people encouraging to come out and help. That's their son, Quentin, doing his own art.
That's fun. He's a fun one.
Yeah, Lily, our friend Lily, did Frida Kahlo. And Matt George did Mother Teresa. Our friend Gene, he did our, this is Rosalind Franklin. Kareem did Maya Angelou.
So beautiful.
Yeah, I loved everyone.
We wanted everybody to do kind of a collage, a portrait. Marie Curie by Lori. There's Gene doing, that's a picture of my sister-in-law, actually, Sienna. And then I painted the future is female and the symbols. Those are the 10 principles. And I put them in an arrangement of the feminine Venus sign. And then they're on site that Saturday before Love Burn started. There's some of our crew helping out. Wally putting up the bass.
A little rainy that day too.
Yeah, it was
lovely.
A little rainy.
It was, yeah. It cooled it off quite nice.
We loved it.
So it was like the end of Sunday, and then this was kind of end of Sunday night.
Loved it.
Yeah, Wally was in love.
I love the hugging. The hugging of it was great.
Yeah. Wally was in love.
Oh, of course.
And then we got some peripheral visions of it, you know, getting some shots from the back side and the front sides. And then we made that altar area because they were going to bring things to burn as an offering to the effigy. And it was great. People like drew and wrote things on the altar area.
Look how great it turned out. I mean, look how well people filled it in with so many messages.
The lighting was fantastic.
I got some great, great video and some great pictures of even the people from the park writing stuff on the effigy.
Nice. Oh, that's awesome.
And the fireworks were fabulous.
They were fabulous. Wally and I got the opportunity to see the burn from the sky bar.
Oh, what a great view.
So we got a great upper deck view. You can see it in part of this video. These are some of the pictures our friends and other attendees took that I kind of swiped off the internet. So
yeah, that's the best way to do it.
Yeah, that video's from us from the sky bar watching.
Look at that aerial view right there. It almost had a full fire tornado going.
Yeah, and the smoke was kind of going into the crowd right where our friends were. There's me from the sky bar with the burn in the back.
Yes. Love that.
And then that was the Sunday night when they took what was left of her that didn't burn.
See, look at it, it's waving goodbye.
Yeah,
that's right. It was a makeshift Sunday. Oh my God, throw it together, DPW rescue. Hi, can we use this head right here?
Exactly.
And it looked like a little arm waving goodbye.
Yeah.
It did.
And that's the sticker I designed to hand out as a gift to people at the burn.
I know. So, what a lovely and beautiful sticker.
So it was a really great experience. I actually was lucky enough. I was out there at one point where the artery came out with tour. And we just happened to be there at the time. And so I got to tell them all about our artists that helped and how we put it together and take pictures with them and stuff. And it was really a fun experience to be out there and be able to kind of give them the docent background
And that was one of the first years we started doing the artery, which was led by Jack Trash. You guys really came together so well, and it was done on such a great timing, you know, mm-hmm. to be able to accomplish the project.
We wanted to make sure it was done
before opening.
We wanted to make sure everybody had something to look at when they came in.
I know it's hard, you know, especially we're lucky because we're only an hour away from where Love Burn is. So, you know, we're closer and, you know, we were able to put more of our budget to building it rather than just the transportation there, which we had help with some of the locals here that helped us out with that. Because I know the year before it was a beautiful effigy too, but unfortunately it was like finishing just before it got burnt and I didn't really get to enjoy it. And so that was really important that we wanted people to be able to really enjoy it and have time with it and really, you know, let it be a centerpiece to the whole weekend.
It was the centerpiece. It was a beautiful centerpiece that people got to write on. They got to interact with. I mean, people got to put their fun elements on top of the shelves.
Nice to see someone bringing their own art to the other artists. It's, you know, compilation of everybody there. And I'm really glad people got to put their stamp on it. I encourage that too. So
It became very interactive that way, as well as people got to add their own flavor to it.
Thank you for watching our rendition of Art at the Love Burn. You got to step inside the artist studio and the process for creating a large interactive art piece at the Love Burn. Learn more at thelovburn.com.